In the desert of NTC, days before Thanksgiving of 2004, 736 men and women came together to form Task Force Eagle Horse. Consisting of a cross-section of soldiers from different specialties, backgrounds, and nationalities, Task Force Eagle Horse, formerly known as 2nd Squadron 11th Armored Cavalry Regiment, came together with one mission in mind: establishing peace in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom. After NTC Rotation 0904, the task force left America in January of 2005, staging in Kuwait to move north into Iraq. While in Kuwait, the task force spent time zeroing small arms and crew-served weapons, as well as firing artillery and mortar rounds. The soldiers also conducted classes in urban warfare, improvised explosive devices, and the rules of engagement. Task Force 211 entered AO battle with an agenda: to neutralize the insurgency by pushing an arc of stability north in support of future elections and reconstruction projects. AO battle was originally controlled by over 1,200 men from two different task forces: Task Force 382 Field Artillery and the 1st Battalion 2nd Landing Team. Task Force 211, on the other hand, consisted of only 736 soldiers. While still flowing in from Kuwait, Task Force Eagle Horse single-handedly conducted RIPTOA activities with two separate units with barely half the other unit's manpower. Area of Operations Battle is a 270 square mile region containing more than 300,000 people. The AO is located on a fault line of Sunni and Shia tensions at the border of the Sunni Triangle. An evergreen region, AO Battle contained 8 cities: Hattin, Eskan, Iskandaria, Haswa, Jifjafa, Hawk, Diyara, and Tunis. Despite the challenge, Task Force Eagle Horse entered the area undaunted. Instead of staying within the confines of their forward operating base, FOB Kalsu, the task force dedicated almost all of its combat power towards operations outside of the wire. Every soldier, regardless of rank, position, and specialty, participated in raids and went on patrols during the first 110 days that Task Force Eagle Horse was on the ground. Shortly after the task force's arrival in Iraq, the squadron worked closely with what would soon become known as the Iraqi Army's 248 Battalion. The task force and these Iraqis worked together to neutralize the insurgency through continuous joint operations. The first step in this campaign began on February 15, 2005, the very day that Task Force Eagle Horse took over AO Battle. During the task force's first raid, Operation DR Sweep, the unit detained 68 insurgents. Roughly a week later, the task force captured 12 insurgents on February 23rd during Operation Hack Away. Together, DR Sweep and Hack Away began to push the arc of stability around AO Battle to the northeast. However, the largest initial push of the arc occurred in the northwestern portion during Operation Haswa Scunyan. On March 5th, after weeks of reconnaissance, the task force conducted a surgical raid in the terrorist hotbed of Haswa, which led 211 to detain 81 insurgents in a matter of hours. During Hattin Mungadai on March 26th, the task force used all available combat power to raid a 9-square-kilometer weapons complex. As a result of that one raid, Task Force Eagle Horse displaced 2 terrorist cells and found 5 weapons caches containing everything from small arms to IED-making materials to rounds of artillery. April was the month when 211 focused on neutralizing the urban fight. To clean out Eskan, Hattin, Haswa, and Iskandaria, the unit conducted multiple task force-level raids within the cities. Over a 24-day period from April 2nd to April 26th, the task force conducted 20 raids in the urban areas. With the urban sector effectively neutralized, the unit focused on the first place where displaced insurgents fled to, the rural neighborhoods to the east known as Shaka and Muela. Along the main road that divides the two areas, Route Cleveland, Task Force Eagle Horse conducted Operation Vigilance. Operation Vigilance, which took place on May 2nd, was a series of 14 small-scale raids that occurred simultaneously within a 90-minute time frame. In the course of Vigilance, the task force detained 45 insurgents. Ultimately, Vigilance and the previous urban raids were so successful that the task force was selected to work with the Polish Army from May 10th to May 25th in support of Operation Stingray. During Stingray, the task force almost doubled the size of its AO. 211 extended its boundary 25 kilometers south to include parts of the Polish Army sector in and around the city of Jabela. While operating in Jabela, the squadron conducted 2 joint raids with the Polish Army while still maintaining the rest of AO Battle. The end of major hostility in AO Battle was marked by Operation Thunder Woodstock. Thunder Woodstock was a series of raids and snap traffic control points that took place between June 3rd and June 5th. Due to the operations that the task force executed between February 15th and June 5th, Task Force 211 detained 271 insurgents and found 20 weapons caches. The unit conducted 44 lethal operations, including air assault missions, 26 raids, 2 cordon and search missions, 1 reconnaissance mission, 1 block and disrupt mission, 1 ambush, and 6 cordon and knock missions at the task force level. While the unit's specialized military training teams answered the call to train and professionalize the Iraqi army, the Eagle Horse Police Partnership Program did a great job of evaluating and improving the 4 police departments in AO Battle, including the construction and renovations of 4 police headquarters buildings. The P3 program allowed Task Force soldiers to train over 200 Iraqi police officers. The period from June 6th to August 21st would be forever remembered as the reconstruction phase of the task force's campaign. Lethal operations continued, however they decreased in volume and scale in direct response to the drop in violence in the area. Instead of conducting large-scale missions, task force leaders gave companies and platoons targets to recon and detain. The onus to service targets fell on the companies, as patrols routinely targeted houses of suspected insurgents. This led to the capture of 67 insurgents and finding 7 weapons caches between June 6th and August 21st. Among the various projects that Task Force Eagle Horse executed was a series of projects that rebuilt and revitalized water pumps, treatment facilities, and pipelines throughout AO Battle. By the end of the reconstruction phase, the stage was set for every home in the area to have access to cleaner water for the first time in over 30 years. Starting with Operation Ubeda Raid on August 22nd, the task force and Iraqi security forces systematically neutralized insurgent activity in preparation for the October 15th referendum. 140 insurgents were captured between August 22nd and October 16th, and 2 weapons caches were uncovered. On October 12th, the task force detained 15 insurgents during Operation Rock the Referendum. Iraqi army and American soldiers passed out flyers and broadcast a message that was clear to all terrorists: get out of town or we will detain or kill you. The mission, which was unique in that it was a lethal operation intended for non-lethal effects, yielded the task force immeasurable success during the October 15th referendum. No terrorist attacks occurred on Election Day, while over 30,000 citizens in AO Battle participated in the democratic process by voting for the referendum. To keep insurgents at bay, the task force executed another large-scale raid less than 4 hours after polling sites closed. During Operation Post-Referendum, which kicked off at 2200 on Election Day, the task force detained 23 insurgents in the urban sector, the same region where it had conducted Rock the Referendum 3 days earlier. Task Force 211 then shaped AO Battle by focusing combat power on Main Supply Route Tampa, a highway that served as Iraq's largest transportation artery connecting Baghdad to Kuwait and the rest of the world. To inhibit IEDs on Route Tampa, Task Force 211 dedicated 1 company per week to the task of patrolling up and down the route. During combat operations between October 17th and December 29th, the task force shifted from focusing on the urban fights in Haswa, Iskandaria, Hattin, and Eskan to the rural challenges in Hak, Diyara, and the Chaka and Ubeda regions. The task force declared that local control had been established in Haswa, Eskan, and Iskandaria on November 15th. Days later, the Iraqi army and Iraqi police assumed complete responsibility for the western portion of AO Battle. By the end of its deployment in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom, Task Force Eagle Horse had detained over 600 insurgents, found more than 50 weapons caches, and reduced improvised explosive devices and indirect fire attacks in the area, thereby fulfilling its objective of neutralizing the insurgency in AO Battle. Thanks to Task Force 211's efforts, 81 reconstruction projects were conducted and over $10 million were injected into the economy of AO Battle. Also, Task Force Eagle Horse successfully professionalized 4 police departments and 1 Iraqi Army battalion. By the end of the deployment, Task Force Eagle Horse had passed out over 25,500 humanitarian aid bags and detained over 60 insurgents through so-called bag and tag operations. The extreme heroism, versatility, and stellar service of the soldiers of Task Force 2nd Squadron 11th Armored Cavalry Regiment made it possible for Task Force Eagle Horse, more than any other battalion, to make what later generations would recognize as an indelible mark on history.